A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 4th September, on the front page you have Amit Shah seeks to reassure Kashmiris. So the Union Home Minister Mr. Amit Shah says nobody's land will be taken away and communication service will be restored within 20 to 25 days. So this is the assurance which has been given to the Kashmiris by the central government. And this is growth blues pull down stocks rupee. So this is regarding Sensex. You can see equities saw their worst single day fall since October 2018 and Indian rupee registered its biggest single day fall in over a month. So this is how growth, lack of growth is affecting the economy. Then below you have disaster keeps some women out of NRC. So this is regarding National Register of Citizens exercise in Assam. So there were two disasters, one caused by water, the flooding, and another caused by fire in adjoining West Bengal district 6 years ago. Within 6 years that have kept several women out of Assam's NRC, which was released on August 31. So in 1968, there was a disastrous flood, and in 1974, a fire which raised much of the district magistrate's office in Kuch Bihar. So because of these, the documents are also lost, it is said, and women have not been able to prove their identity, and that's why they are now out of the NRC. Then this is Indian Air Force inducts 8 Apache attack helicopters. So this is the most advanced multi-role heavy attack helicopter in the world, which has been inducted by the Indian Air Force into service. It's a US made helicopter and said to be the most advanced in the world, and it will replace Mi-35 fleet of the Indian Air Force, which has been purchased from Russia. Then below you have district magistrate defense booking scribe for expose. So this was a journalist who had done a video shooting of midday meal at primary school in Mirzapur, and the poor quality of the food here had been evident, and the video had gone viral. So the police here have booked the journalist. So the district magistrate also defends this act. He says that the journalist, he worked for print media, so there was no need for shooting a video for the print media, but he did that to make it viral. So it was a part of a conspiracy. But then the fact is that an expose has happened. The poor quality of midday meal here has come forth, but the journalist has been booked. On page 8, you have Karnataka, Maharashtra oppose AP demand on Krishna water. So the chief ministers of the two states met and they discussed the challenge the plea for reallocation after creation of Telangana. So this is regarding Krishna water dispute. The Krishna water dispute tribunal has been challenged and Andhra Pradesh wants reallocation after Telangana has been created out of it. But Maharashtra and Karnataka have jointly opposed this demand. It has been its stand for long now. So both the states have taken a firm stand that Andhra Pradesh and Telangana should take water from the allotted share. Means they want the share of United Andhra Pradesh to be bifurcated amongst Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. The two states share, which has been finalized by the Water Dispute Tribunal, Krishna Water Dispute Tribunal, should not be tinkered with. So actually another problem is that the present floods have created problem for both. So there's a need for better dam management to avoid floods, and that's why the two state chief ministers also met and they have talks about how to manage the floods and how water should be shared amongst the two in flood situations. So the two states have sparred over signing a MOU to exchange 4 TMC feet of water in each side of the border on the condition that Karnataka returns 10.787 TMC feet at the end of the agreement period. So Maharashtra should give to Karnataka, Karnataka should give back. So that is what is being discussed here. Then on page 9 you have 4 more states join ration card portability. So the central government is planning a nationwide launch of ration card portability by June 2020. Presently 4 more states have joined. These are Kerala, Karnataka, Rajasthan and Haryana. So it means that they can buy ration card holders can buy subsidized food from ration cards in the neighboring states also, any state. So where their portability is there. Then, this is India faces high mortality from cardiovascular diseases. So, despite lower risk factors, low-income countries report higher deaths in indoor pollution emerging as a major threat. So, indoor pollution is a major threat because of which low-income countries report higher deaths due to cardiovascular diseases. The risk factors here are low, obesity, etc. compared to developed countries, but mortality is high. Then this is Supreme Court to study petition for food for all. So the Supreme Court has agreed to examine a plea that starvation deaths continue to eat into the right to life and dignity of social fabric, and a radical new measure like community kitchens need to be set up across the country to feed the poor and the hungry. So state funded community kitchens should be there is the demand, and this petition will be heard by the Supreme Court. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is A Life in the Balance. So this is regarding Kulbhushan Jadhav, who is under arrest in Pakistan on charges of espionage and terrorism. So it says that India must use all available channels with Pakistan to negotiate a reprieve for Jadhav. And the second editorial is On the Edge. So this is regarding how far-reaching reforms are required to keep the economy from stalling. Otherwise, economy will take a dive, and that is inevitable if far-reaching reforms are not brought in. And the lead article is A Democratic Language, an Authoritarian Writ. So this is regarding how powerful populists are holding representative institutions hostage to their own project of power. So we need democracy in the country. We do not need authoritarian governance. So that's what is spoken of in this article. And this is Putting the Skids Under Border Trade. So this is regarding India-Pakistan standoff, which is having more repercussions than intended, with border economy is the worst hit. So border trade has been affected. So that is discussed here. Then on the op-ed page, you have here Pakistan's minority problem. So it's talking about how instead of vilifying India, Pakistan Prime Minister should first set his house on order. House in order. On page 12, you have Modi expected to sign major LNG pact with Russia. So India plans to make new investments in Russian oil fields. So liquefied natural gas pact will be signed, and this will be to import LNG from Russia. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be on a visit to Vladivostok when this deal will be signed. Then on page 13, you have old promises and new package. So 6,000 of the 50,000 vacancies will be filled in Jammu and Kashmir as part of the Prime Minister's 2015 package. So that has not been fulfilled yet. So here you can see how vacancies will be filled is being put forth. So this is there. So trying to bring in peace and normalcy in Jammu and Kashmir. These are the steps being announced. Then the Defense Minister Rajnath Singh is on a visit to Pakistan, to Japan, and in Japan he discusses Indo-Pacific cooperation. So the two nations have shared their views on cooperation in the region. So it has been long discussed issue, Indo-Pacific region, cooperation in the region. So it's basically in context of the South China Sea and how developments in the Korean Peninsula affect the region. On international page, you have Boris Johnson loses parliament majority. So Prime Minister Boris Johnson has lost his working majority in parliament ahead of a showdown with rebel MPs over Brexit. So this could lead to snap elections within weeks. So this is how Brexit has been thought to be delayed here, you can see. And here you have explosion rocks Kabul as US peace deal with Taliban nears. So an explosion took place in which 16 civilians were killed and 119 wounded. And then here you can see in Hong Kong, the executive leader, Carrie Lam, she says she continued to stay on the post, and she clarifies she never considered resigning. And this is no water storage projects in Tibet, says China. So one hydropower plant has been built and two others are under construction on Yalung Zhangbo River, which is the name of Brahmaputra River in China. So it says there is no storage involved in these projects. Then on business page you have anchor bank stocks in free fall. So government announced merger of 10 public sector banks into 4 banks, and now banks which have the lowest NPAs among the banks chosen for merger, which is called the anchor bank, has been worst hit with the shares declining almost 12%. So anchor bank stocks have taken a free fall. Indian Bank, which is the bank with the lowest NPA among public sector bank merger candidates, is the worst hit. And then here you have GST returns forms too complex to meet filing deadline. So small businesses face huge challenge in preparing GSTR 9, the form GSTR 9, which has to be filled for tax filing, and the new deadline is November 30. And this is task force recommends online loan sale platform. So central loan contract registry has been suggested by TN Manoharan committee as such, which was a task force. He is the chairman of Canara Bank, and the task force said that a self-regulatory body of participants should be formed to finalize detailed modalities for the secondary market for corporate loans, including standardization of documents. So online loan sale platform is being suggested. And then here you have cabinet approves higher procurement price for ethanol. So Union Cabinet has approved a higher procurement price for ethanol purchase, which will be done by oil marketing companies for ethanol blended petrol, which is a program which will come into effect from 1st December, and it will be going on for 1 year. So the sugar factories, they are also dealing under pressure. So here you can see ethanol procurement price has been increased. Then on page 17 you have FinTech panel bats for virtual banks easing KYC norms. So this is regarding the steering committee on financial technology, FinTech. It has submitted its report to the finance minister, in which it recommends allowing the operation of virtual banks, ensuring know your customer procedure, easing know your customer procedures, and also implementing FinTech to prevent fraud and incentivizing NBFCs, non-banking finance companies, to increase lending to the agriculture sector. So these are some of the recommendations which have been given by this steering committee, which was formed in March 2018 under the chairmanship of Economic Affairs Secretary. Then there's sports news on the last page. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.